So we're here in the AMD tent at CES, and we're showing off the Star Swarm demo of Oxide Games' next-gen strategy engine, which we're calling the Nitrous Engine. Oxide's Nitrous Engine uses AMD's Mantle API in a way that really improves our performance. Mantle is really good at being multi-threaded, and Nitrous Engine really likes to be multi-threaded. So we're able to scale very, very efficiently using Mantle on multi-core CPUs. So the using Mantle as the API instead of DirectX really allows us to be as efficient as possible with our code, which ends up being, it ends up seeing really significant real-world performance gains. Even in, you can see in our demo, this is a live gameplay simulation. These units are running AI, they're doing all the things that you're gonna see in a game, and the performance delta between Mantle and other renderers is really significant. So at Oxide, we've been making 3D engines for a really long time, and we've been waiting for something like Mantle and asking for something like Mantle for a really long time. So when AMD came to us a little while back and showed us Mantle and what they were doing with it, we were really excited. So we got on board right away and started up on Mantle. And after about 6 weeks of work for one of our engineers, who, to be fair, he's a really good engineer, after about 6 weeks of work, we had Nitrous up and running on Mantle. Using Mantle, we're able to crank up a lot of our visual effects that we're not able to get simply for performance reasons. Because it frees up so much computing power, we're able to turn that computing power into better looking graphics. So we're able to get much more exciting graphics, things like motion blur, at a really high sample rate, using Mantle that we just can't do on current hardware using other APIs. We want to enable new kinds of gaming experiences. Like, we want to enable things like the Battle of Helm's Deep so that it's you can see those that scale of battle and epic scenes so that strategy gaming doesn't have to be 12 Space Marines versus 6 bugs, right? We want to have 5,000 Space Marines versus 5,000 bugs, which are the kind of numbers that we're seeing. We have currently, we have over 7,000 units in the simulation right now, all running AI, all shooting their weapons individually, which are all individually tracked. And that number is, we've seen that number get up to about 10,000 and be able to maintain a frame rate north of 30 on current hardware. And we hope to get that number even higher. So as you can see, Star Swarm is really, it's really about opening new doors for game designers and game developers to create new kinds of strategy games. So we already have 3 games in development, one at Oxide, one at Stardock Baltimore, which is Star Control, and one at Soren Johnson's Mohawk Games, all actively in development using the Nitrous Engine right now. This is running on a 290X graphics card, which is a wonderful top-of-line GPU from AMD, and an AMD FX 8350 processor, which is a great processor, but we actually have this down clock to half speed on the CPU. The FX 8350 is running at only 2 gigahertz, and we're still GPU bound. We're able to keep the GPU, the top-of-the-line GPU, fully fed with a half-speed CPU using Mantle, because Mantle lets us scale that efficiently to multiple cores. Once some of these games start coming out, I think people are going to see that there's a whole new world of gaming out there that we're really excited to be able to make that happen, right? We're excited to use new technologies like Mantle that allow us to create some of these really epic scenes that we're really excited about, because we're gamers ourselves and we love to see this stuff. So new technologies like Mantle, you know, we're excited to get on the consoles. We fully intend Nitrous to be a console gaming engine as well as a PC gaming engine to support all relevant platforms that support high-end gaming, right? We're taking the first step today with Star Swarm, which is going to be releasing later in January to the public, so you'll be able to play it through Steam, play it on your machine, see how it works for yourself. We're just really excited to take that first step toward what we think is a really bright future for strategy games.
CES is a wonderful time for us to get together and really talk about all of the innovations that are going to be important this year and in the coming years.